Hi, everyone. This is Concrete and Cranes VBS 2020. I'm Kelly, and I'm doing the music with you guys. I hope you guys have fun and enjoy it.
Day came, Renzo Wright, boy genius and youngest architect in the country, was chosen to make the largest building in the world. It was his first day on the job, and it's fair to say he was a little intimidated, which is just a fancy word for nervous.
Wow, it's a lot taller than I imagined it.
We need more blockos.
Renzo Tower, world's biggest building. Soon, pressure's on the boy genius.
I'm not worried at all. No problem.
The first skyscraper was built over 100 years ago and reached 10 stories tall. Today on this site, Renzo Wright shall build for Kitten Construction, Inc., the tallest and best building ever. Isn't that right, young man?
Yes, ma'am. I will build it perfectly.
He's going up to the clouds. Let's go again.
Lloyd.
With the opening ceremony over, it was time to meet the construction foreman, Mr. Santiago. Mr. Santiago believed in Renzo's plan completely.
Worst plans I've ever seen.
All due respect, Mr. Santiago, I spent the whole weekend making those.
Yeah, 170 stories, huh?
Can I drive the blue thingy?
Huh? Son, you should not operate anything out here.
It's 171 stories, actually. Check out the treehouse deck.
Look, kid, this is a heavy construction, cranes and concrete. Building a skyscraper means deadlines, hard work, and always following the rules. We've got a lot to do in a short time.
I know all this. I built lots of buildings.
With toy blocks, not real machines.
I'm not operating on it. I'm driving it.
Cease operation! Cease operation!
It's a bulldozer, but it seems wide awake!
Kid, get down from there! Get down from there!
Mr. Santiago, allow me to demonstrate my serious skills.
Renzo, what are you doing?
Proving my work!
Oh! Lloyd, cease operations!
I'm digging for worms! Digging for worms!
No!
Mr. Santiago, it isn't safe for you!
It isn't safe for me?
There really should be an age limit out here.
Stop this crazy thing!
Say, Mr. Santiago, where's the off button?
Oh, melted rainbow!
I suppose I should learn a few more things before I start giving orders.
Giving orders? Giving orders? Why, you ought to be given apologies.
If you want to make an omelet, you gotta break a few eggs, Mr. Santiago.
Omelet? Omelet?
Santiago, what are you doing making a mess out here? Embarrassing us in front of the genius kid. Go clean yourself up.
Nine.
Renzo, we have a problem.
Extra, extra! Cobra Cone Construction promises to build bigger, better, and faster than Boy Genius. Read all about it. Extra!
If you want to keep your special floor, you got to deliver. Bigger, faster, and better.
For the first time in his life, Renzo needed help. The truth is, Renzo really messed up, but he was not ready to admit it. Pride is a tricky thing. It causes all kinds of problems. Renzo had a lot to learn about asking for forgiveness. But fortunately, someone in his life was praying, and maybe it's not who you think.
Lord, please, help us forgive this boy. Give me patience with him. If we could survive him, that would be good too.
Welcome to day 2 of missions, VBS 2020, it's preschool missions, and I'm so excited to tell you about another missionary family. And you guys remember what a missionary is, right? It's people who go and tell people about Jesus. Well, today, the missionary that we're going to learn about lives on an island in Puerto Rico. Here, this is where we live in America. And they live on an island in the Caribbean Sea in Puerto Rico. Well, while they were there, there was a big hurricane that came. And a big hurricane, it caused so much damage that strong winds, they knocked out the water and the electricity. Well, you guys, I want you to think about that for a second. If you went to go wash your hands, and you went to the sink to wash your hands, and no water came out, what would you do? Where would you go get water? Okay, now think about electricity. You wanted to watch cartoons, and you went to turn on the TV, but you could not watch the TV. It would not turn on because there is no electricity. So the people on the island in Puerto Rico, they had no electricity, no water. So we're gonna learn about what the missionary did to help meet the needs of the people so he could share Jesus with them. So I want you guys to watch this video, and then I'll ask you some questions when it's over. So make sure you have your listening ears on so you can listen really good so we can talk about what you saw, okay?
Jorge Santiago was beginning to start a new church in his Puerto Rican hometown of Comerío in 2017. That's when Hurricane Maria hit the entire island so hard that the people here are still trying to recover.
When I think about the damage that Hurricane Maria caused in Comerío, I was so heartbroken because I knew my people need help.
So one of the first things Jorge did was help the people of Comerio wash their clothes. They set up 3 washing machines and a generator and invited anyone to come and do their laundry. That got people's attention. Even the mayor was impressed.
The churches have come to do the true work of missions. The hand of a friend to people who are hurting. Many have not received help from the government, but the church has been there, and they value that.
That's when a group called Send Relief came to town. It is made up of mission teams from churches across the United States. They came to help Jorge fix people's homes and tell them about Jesus. And the city mayor helped too.
We found that the city has carpenters that work for the city. And I said, give me one. Give me one carpenter, and I put a team of volunteers with them, and we can help people rebuild their houses.
What happened next changed that carpenter's life, helped give the people of Comerio homes where they can live again, and the start of a new church.
God started putting that heavy weight in my heart. It was like, I need to preach the gospel. I have to. So it wasn't a feeling. It was clear, you need to start preaching.
Okay guys, so one way to be a missionary also is to go and help the people who have had a very hard time from that hurricane. And do you guys remember how the missionary helped the people there on the island? What did he do? He helped them wash their clothes. And there was also a team from the United States that came there to help rebuild the homes. And that's a wonderful way that people are able to share Jesus with people. So today, we're going to pray for the people in Puerto Rico and for our missionary there, that he can continue to meet the people's needs and share Jesus with them, okay? So let's pray. Let's pray for our missionary. Lord, we just want to lift up our missionary that is in Puerto Rico, and we pray that you will continue to help him meet the needs of the people so that they will come to know Jesus. And God, I pray that you will continue to send workers to help rebuild from the storm. And God, we pray that one day that the kids watching this will want to go and share Jesus with others, just like they are seeing on the videos. We love you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, that's all for today. Thank you for watching the missions.
Welcome to VBS 2020 Concrete and Cranes Day 2. If you got your bag handy, since it's Day 2, we're going to do 2 things, and I'm Jill Haney. We're going to do the sticker scenes, pull that out, and also pull this out, which it looks like this, and you also got markers. So, the sticker scene is a piece of paper, and you stick the stickers on the piece of paper. So here we go. And you can do it any way you want. It's your own personal thing. And then you can hang it up on the fridge. So just keep going with that. And you got your own sticker scene. Next, get your block out. Open it up and let your parents help you with the plastic bags. Do not put them anywhere they shouldn't be. Make sure you put them in the trash. Safety first, remember. So take your markers that you got in your bag, and they can be different colors. It does not matter if you got some at home, and start coloring. and continue coloring until it's all finished. And it should look like this, your own personal idea. And I will see you on day 3.
Hi, I'm Linda, and I'm back again today for day 2. Today we're doing a preschool Bible story again, and we're back at our construction site again. Hope you get a chance to really look at this. It's pretty great. Remember our story from yesterday? We were talking about Matthew and the reason that Jesus came to show God's love for everyone. And that point was God chooses to love me, and he also chooses to love you. And our verse, remember Philippians 1:6, I know that God started a good work in me, and he will complete it. You want to say that with me again? I know that God started a good work in me, and he will complete it. So yesterday we were using our hammers, and today I have another tool. I have a flashlight. The flashlights can be pretty bright. Shine them in your eyes, they hurt, don't they? Well, today we have a story about a man named Paul, and he's going to see a very bright light. And when you have a bright light shining in your face, it's pretty bright, it hurts your eyes. So we're going to listen to this story about Paul and find out what happened to Paul in his bright light. The lesson's found in Acts 26, verses 1 through 20, and this story is titled, Paul Listened and He Obeyed. So let's read our story. One day Paul was traveling to a city named Damascus. He was going there because he did not like people who loved Jesus. Paul wanted to hurt them and put them in jail. But on his way, something really amazing happened. Paul saw a bright light, even brighter than the sun, it says. So why don't you close your eyes? Because boy, if you see a light brighter than the sun, you have to close your eyes because it hurts. It was so bright, it hurt his eyes, and Paul could not see. He fell to the ground. Paul heard a voice ask why he was hurting people. And this scared Paul because he couldn't see anyone talking. Paul asked who the voice was. And the voice answered, I am Jesus. And Jesus told Paul to go and tell people that God loves him. You can open your eyes now. When Paul could see again, Paul obeyed Jesus. He changed the way he lived, and he didn't hurt people anymore. He told people about what happened to him and that God loves them no matter what they have done. So instead of Paul going to hurt these people, he actually changed. And he went and he told them that God loves them no matter what they've done. So that's the lesson, the point that we want to remember in today's lesson. That God loves people no matter what they've done. And God loves you no matter what. I love you all too. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Hi guys, welcome back to VBS. This is day 2 and we're gonna do blueprint. So stand up and let's have fun.